Hi students, today we'll be studying about the anatomy of the neck. This is Dr. Yusuf, and these are the specific objectives which are followed in the College of Medicine, Al Jawf University. The first objective is describe fascia of the neck and give their importance. The second one is enumerate the structures in the anterior median plane of the neck from above downwards. Third is mention the actions and nerve supply of sternocleidomastoid muscle, mention its relations and clinical importance. Fourth is outline the triangles of the neck and list the contents of each. Fifth is identify the suprahyoid as well as the infrahyoid muscles and give their actions and nerve supply. So these are some of the objectives which we will discuss one by one. To begin with, if you see the neck is a very important structure through which the lower part of the body will be in connection with the head and neck. So a lot of structures will be entering from the lower part, from the thoracic region to the head and neck, and many structures will be descending downwards from the head and neck into the thoracic region, and this connection is very important here. And this is confined to a very small area called as the neck. Before we discuss about the neck itself, we'll be discussing when we reflect the skin and the superficial fascia, there is a very important fascia, deep fascia, called as the deep cervical fascia of the neck, which is also called as the fascia coli. This is the fascia which covers all the structures of the neck and gives an additional support as well as covering. So to define, it is a fascia which invests the muscles of the neck and fulfills and fills up the interval between muscles, vessels and cervical viscera. So it's a fascia which invests the muscles of the neck. So it covers totally the muscles of the neck, gives protection to that, gives an additional support and fills the interval between muscles, vessels and cervical viscera. So it covers the structures separately, the vessels and the cervical viscera, which are there like the trachea itself, the esophagus, the thyroid gland. All these are covered by a special fascia which is called as the deep cervical fascia of the neck. It has three layers or three parts. One is called as the investing layer of the deep cervical fascia, which is the outermost covering. If you see here in this picture, this is how it looks like. To be more precise, we'll go to the next picture here. If you can see here, this is the cross section of the neck seen from above, and you can see here the blue colored line just below the skin and the platysma muscle. Here there is a deep fascia. This blue line is called as the investing layer of deep cervical fascia. It is covering the whole of the neck as well as it is giving extra support as well as covering to the muscles here, both in the anterior part as well as the posterior part. Here if you see, this is the sternocleidomastoid muscle, behind it is the trapezius muscle. So it covers on either side of these muscles. Okay, so this fascia, which is outermost of the three fascias which cover the whole of the neck, this is the investing layer of deep cervical fascia. The second fascia is called as pretracheal fascia, which is in front of the trachea. So that's why it is called as pretracheal. It can be much more clearly seen in this picture, the cross section, where it is around the trachea. This is the trachea here, and here is the esophagus, and these are the two lobes of the thyroid gland, and around that there is a fascia which is covering. This is called as the pretracheal fascia because it is in front of the trachea, so it is called as pre means front. So pretracheal fascia is the fascia which covers the not only in the front of the trachea, sides as well as behind, not only the trachea itself but also the thyroid gland, esophagus and other structures. Then the third fascia is there, which is around the vertebra. This is called as the prevertebral because it is in front of the vertebras. In this picture, if you see here, these are the vertebras, this is the spinal cord, and in front of that you can see there is a fascia. This is called as the prevertebral fascia. to be more precise, in this picture is much more clear. Here you can see the vertebral column, and this is the spinal cord inside, and around that there are important muscles surrounding this vertebral column itself. And of the whole of this structures, the muscles, the vertebra itself, the spinal cord, everything is covered by a additional fascia around all these structures, and this is called as the prevertebral fascia. So it is mentioned here, the prevertebral, this pink line, this is the prevertebral fascia. This orange line, this is the pretracheal fascia, and the outermost is the, of the three fascias, this is the investing layer of the cervical. These are the fascias which are around the neck and covering very important structures in the neck. Along with that, there is an additional fascia which covers some very important structure, especially here. If you can see here, this is the fascia, and it covers very important structures like the common carotid artery. So that's why it is called as the carotid sheath, because it covers the common carotid artery as well as its terminal branches, the external and internal carotid artery, especially the external carotid. Then this is the internal jugular vein, and here is the vagus nerve. There are three important structures within this carotid sheath. This is the common carotid artery and its branches, terminal branches. This is the internal jugular vein, and this is the vagus nerve. All these three structures are covered by a special covering. This is called as the carotid sheath. This is also part of the deep cervical fascia. So all these fascia are the part of the deep cervical fascia of the neck, which is also called as the fascia coli. So these fascia will divide the whole of neck into compartment. One is called as the visceral compartment. Viscera means the organs, like the pretracheal as well as the prevertebral fascia, where there are important structures like the trachea, esophagus, thyroid gland, and other structures. So because these fascia, this part of the fascia will be covering important structures there, the organs, viscera. So that's why it is called as the visceral compartment. So this is the visceral compartment where the important viscera like esophagus, trachea, thyroid gland, and here the vertebral column itself, the spinal cord, the muscles. So all these, the prevertebral and pretracheal fascia will be called as the visceral compartment. There is also a very important component. This is called as the neurovascular compartment. Neuro means nerves, and vascular means vessels, the arteries and the vein. So this is in case of the carotid sheath, where it is covering very important neurovascular components. Neuro is the nerve, that is the vagus nerve here, and the vascular, that is the artery and the vein, the common carotid artery, as well as the internal jugular vein. All these structures are covered by a separate part of the deep cervical fascia. So this will divide this into a separate neurovascular compartment. Okay, so this is called as the neurovascular compartment, inside which the carotid sheath, where the internal carotid artery, the internal jugular vein, and the vagus are present. Why there should be fascia? So some of the important functions of the fascia of the neck have been mentioned here. First of all, it acts as a covering and also as a protective barrier. After the skin, this will act as the second layer of defensive mechanism for any kind of external attack by bacteria, virus, or anything like that. So it acts as a protective barrier, as well as it acts as a covering to all the structures in the neck. There are very important structures in the neck, so it has to be covered by extra structures. So this is called as the this is the covering of the neck, as well as also it acts as a protective barrier. It gives passage to very important structures, as I said, like the nerves and arteries. If you can see here, it is giving passage from the artery, like the common carotid artery. It is passing from the thorax, and it is going into the head and neck part, and it supplies, it gives the arteries, the branches, two terminal branches, the external carotid artery as well as the internal carotid artery. Internal carotid artery will be one of the two important arteries which will supply the brain, and the external carotid artery will be supplying all the structures in the neck as well as the face. So these are very important structures which are passing from the thorax into the head and neck part. Also the vein, The internal jugular vein is draining the head and neck and face and brain into back into the thoracic region, as well as the vagus nerve, which is one of the cranial nerve, which is coming from the brain, and it supplies very important structures. It acts as a component of the autonomic nervous system, and it will be supplying not only the heart, the lungs, the GIT, many structures. So this fascia will be a very important, it gives passage for very, very important structures to move upward and downwards smoothly without any hindrance. The third thing, important feature of this importance of this fascia is, if there is in case of any infection, then the pus will be confined to that area. If there is some infection here in this component or here somewhere, so it will be confined to that part. It doesn't spread to the all of the neck. So again, as I said, there are very important structures in the neck. So if there is any infection, so it should not spread to other parts. So because of this fascia, the infections and the pus collection will be confined to that particular area, and it prevents the spreading of infection from one part to the other side. If there is any infection here, it will not go to the other side or to here or somewhere else. So this fascia will act as a barrier from the spread of any infection to any other parts. Fourth is, it gives additional support to the muscles and other structures. If you see here, the sternocleidomastoid or trapezius, they have their own origin and insertion. That is the actually support, the support of that muscle. But additionally, this fascia will, if you can see here, it is totally covered by this fascia. This fascia splits into two, the anterior layer and posterior layer, and it totally covers this muscle. This is giving an additional support to these muscles and other structures. So here also you can see the carotid sheath is covering the structure, the arteries and the vein and the nerve, and giving an additional support. So this fascia will also act as a very important structure, which will give additional support to muscles and other structures. So these are some of the importance of having a fascia in the neck. One, it acts as a covering. Second, it protects acts as a protective barrier and protects from the infection, like any bacteria or virus or something like that. It gives important passage for the structures, important structures like the nerves, arteries and the veins. And if there is any infection, it will be confined to that area and prevents the spread of infection and the pus to other parts. And fourthly, it gives additional support to muscles and other structures. So these are some of the importance of the fascia in the neck.